It is the stuff of legends, where legacies are created and history is made. The season of sweat and toil, merely a prelude, a dress rehearsal for the ultimate challenge, where echoes of past triumphs still linger. For those who dare to reach for greatness, destiny awaits. This is the NBA playoffs.
Always a majestic view of the War Memorial here in downtown Indianapolis. Round one of the East rolls on. Game two alongside Steve Kerr and Clark Kellogg. This is Kevin Harlan. Playoff basketball on 2K Sports. You'll see Atlanta facing the Indiana Pacers. And now we take a brief check at the matchups. Our starting five for both teams. And guys, what do you think we'll be seeing from Jeff Teague in this one?
If there's one thing he does better than anything else, it's just his ability to weave his way through all kinds of traffic on a fast break and find himself at the rim.
He's always in danger of going rack to rack.
Look at Indiana. Tough loss for them in game one. We'll see if they can rally back in front of their hometown crowd to tie the series.
And Kevin, this virtually becomes a must-win situation because of that loss in game one. It happens so rarely that a team loses the first two games at home and ends up winning a playoff series.
Yeah, they'll be stumbling if this one gets away from them, no doubt. Having to hit the road knowing they need to win two games in hostile territory. But if they right the ship here today, I think it'll be anybody's series.
And that one's good. Hibbert's got the first basket of the game for Indiana.
A good way to get things started here.
Steve, always nice to get the first points up on the board. At least I felt that way.
Unloads from 13, and he gets it to go, hitting off the back of the rim. And here are the Pacers now, coming to this game after losing on Saturday.
And, you know, coming down the stretch in that game, they didn't have all the guys they would have liked on the floor because of the foul trouble they were in.
And as a result, Steve, they had to back down a little bit so they wouldn't get themselves into even more foul trouble.
Six on the shot clock. Here's Stevenson, sinks it from just inside the baseline. About 1 minute into the first quarter. Now here's Teague. Teague left side, into Millsap. That's good, and so Teague with the assist. Millsap's got his first points in this one. And so it's Indiana with it. Hill kicks to George. Inside to Hibbert. And he gets it to go. Hibbert's got his second bucket of the game to go.
Pretty, pretty passive. Timely recognition as to where the open man was.
Millsap sets the pick for Teague. An easy layup after coming off the pick.
Perfect screen there. Set him up with a nice look.
Poor job by the defender to not fight over or around that screen.
Hill gets a screen from Hibbert. Hill kicks it to West. Soft touch up for Bucks. West has got his first bucket of the night.
Four makes on four tries. Everything's falling early. 100% can't do better than that.
Here's Teague. The shot no good. So Indiana will take it the other way. George passes to Hill. Here in the first, just under 2.5 minutes played so far. And so it looks like the Pacers will retain possession here. Now that we have a moment, let's see who the best passing teams were in the regular season. The Hawks second.
You know, sometimes it's tough to give up the ball to a teammate, but the good teams do it. They don't settle for just a good shot. They're looking for the best shot. And these guys have been unselfish all season long.
Now, here is George. 14 feet away.
First miss of the game after four makes, so it's been a hot start.
Here's Carroll. Marvelous lead pass, and he throws it down.
Well, you knew he'd win that race.
Definitely. I mean, that's what you call early offense.
And here is Hill. The feed to Hibbert. And George kicks it to West. Millsap with the steal.
Korver off the pick from Millsap. Korver dishes to Millsap. That puts them in the lead.
The screenplay worked ideally there, and I'm not talking about the screenplay you see in a movie theater. Gave him more than enough room to get that shot off.
Now, here is Hill. Outside, George. Tipped away. Out of bounds, Atlanta will take possession. Keldon Brands checked in for the Hawks. Mike Scott comes in for Paul Millsap. Just under 3.5 minutes gone here in the first quarter. Williams gets a screen from Scott. Williams attacking. So he gets the whistle. Contact on the way up and two shots coming up.
What he does defensively for his team is takes pressure off the other four guys because he hardly ever needs help. He can fight through screens and always manages to stay in front of his man.
Yeah, he's a pit bull type defender. I mean, he just doesn't give in or give up, Steve.
First one falls for him. Throws good for Williams.
Well, you kind of expect that from him. You pretty much know what the result's going to be when he goes to the line.
Outside, George, and it's Hill penetrating. And fouled hard that time. He'll get to the line and shoot two.
You know, even from here, you could see that one pretty clearly.
Yep, pretty obvious. And a good call by the official.
The Pacers shooting their first free throws of the game. And that one misses. Max checked in for Atlanta. And he sinks the second. The Hawks leading by three. And now the fast break. Stevenson with the ball. Outside turning. He kicks it to Hill. Some nice passing here by Indiana. Dishes to Stevenson. Outside Hill. Six to shoot. Here's Turner. Gets it to go from 18 feet away. Turner's got his first 2 points of the night for Atlanta. They've gone 5-7 today so far. Nice shooting to get this game underway. Back the pass to Williams. Wide open look. That's good on the jump shot.
Easy little jump shot for him right there, guys.
And it's the Pacers with the ball. It's a 3-point game. Hill kicks to Stevenson. Here's Turner. Buries it from three-point range. Turner's got his second bucket of the night.
Well, I'm not necessarily a big fan of him shooting that shot, but they did give him the space.
Here's Matt. He's guarded by Hill. 58 seconds left in the first quarter. They get the rebound. Grant. And it's blocked by Mahinmi. For Indiana, they've gotten 6 or 7 shots to fall in the first quarter. They're off and running. Hill dishes to Mahinmi. Scola inside. He's guarded by Korver. For three, Hill. Rebound, Atlanta.
Almost surprised that he had that much room to work with.
We've got a 9-second difference between the shot clock and the game clock. And fouled hard that time. He'll get to the line and shoot two.
Great job. Take it right at the defense. I like the aggressiveness.
Yeah, he left them no choice but to foul there.
The Atlanta shooting their third and fourth free throw shots of the night. Falls for Williams. Damari Carroll's checked in for Kyle Korver. And that's good as he hits both of his shots. Just 1 second between the shot clock and game clock. Watson kicks to Stevenson. Outside Turner. He feeds it to Scola from six away. And once again off the mark by Indiana. For three, Williams. A nice first quarter of play. We've seen plenty of offense so far.
Western Conference, round one. Kevin Durant and the Oklahoma City Thunder go up against Zach Randolph and the Memphis Grizzlies. Live this Thursday night.
A lot of success from mid-range so far for them, guys. If nothing else works, they can always fall back on the jump shot.
And the other thing they're doing is forcing a lot of turnovers, and that's helping them to get easy points at the other end.
All fueled up and ready to go. Let's reset the lineups courtesy of Gatorade as the second quarter gets going. On the court right now for the Hawks. Teague out there with Shelvin Mack. Then it's Damari Carroll. Then there's Paul Millsap. And it's Antic in at the pivot spot, manning the middle. The Hawks have been solid at the line so far, 4 for 4. Free throw, no good. He hits the second from the line. Pacers trail by three. Watson with it. To the inside. Turner. That's good. And the assist goes to Watson. And that's now 7 points for Evan Turner.
Took advantage of some shoddy defense there. They've got to at least get a finger on it.
Outside Teague. He dishes it to Kill. Fires the three. And Teague is good for three. Teague's got the lead up to four now for Atlanta.
Oh, he's going to keep banging those home if you give him that much space.
Pass to Hibbert. Using his post moves to get the 2 points. Hibbert's got six.
Heads up play there, guys, on the assist and the finish.
Here's Matt Turner covering. The shot is off. And Indiana will go the other way with it. A minute and a half gone here in the second quarter. Teague against George. Out of bounds, Atlanta will take possession. And on your screen now are the steal leaders from the small forward spot during the regular season. A very strong defensive group, to say the least. Paul George on top.
He is a pest out there on the wing. One slip of concentration, one careless pass, and he'll be going the other way with it.
Quickness and awareness, Steve, and that makes him a superior defender. I mean, as his ranking indicates, he possibly is the best defensive small forward in the league.
And now the first timeout called here for the Hawks. Atlanta making a switch here. Korver's checked in. A moment to check in with Doris Burke. Doris?
Yes, guys, Mike Budenholzer had some words for his team. He mentioned the need for more use of the pick and roll. It's a basic component of their offense that he said he hasn't seen nearly enough of. Maybe making those early adjustments will give them time to judge their effectiveness by halftime. We'll soon find out, Kevin.
Thanks a lot, Doris.
Well, an illegal screen is one of the toughest calls for the official to make.
You know, I agree with you. You've got to have some sympathy for the referees when they have to make calls like that, but they get paid well, and they're the best in the business, so they can handle it.
Hill passes to Turner. It's back to Hill. George, that's a two-pointer. Misses off the left iron. The Hawks leading. To the left side wing. Pass to T. And the shot is good. Teague's got 5 points now in the quarter. Pacers have gone 2 of 4 shooting the ball here in the second. Hill kicks to Turner. Some nice passing here by Indiana. West a screen on Teague. From deep, George. Good, and it's Hill picking up the assist.
Boy, that was a rugged screen set there, fellas, and the defense didn't even try to go through that.
And Atlanta has possession. Teague gets a screen from Untich. Teague dishes to Matt. Turner with the steal. And now here's George, the fast break opportunity.
The defense to start and ignite that play was terrific, and I love the fact that they attacked early in the shot clock.
And now that they have the lead, they might even want to get more aggressive defensively. Really attack, try to come up with more steals.
Miami's checked in for Roy Hibbert. The Pacers shooting their third free throw shot of the game.
At the line for one.
And the free throw, no good. The Hawks trail it. Millsap sets the pick for T. Kicks it to Millsap. Lays it in without an inch of room around him. Millsap's got 6 points.
Sloppy defense there. You can't let him get the ball in his hands down there.
Well, when he does, that's an automatic bucket.
To West. It's back to Hill. And the foul called on Paul Millsap. That's foul number 2 for him.
That's foul number 2 on him. It might not warrant sitting him entirely, but another one before halftime, they could be in some trouble.
Eldon Brand's checked in for the Hawks. Mike Scott comes in for Paul Millsap. Outside for George. Uses the glass to finish the layup. 7 points in the game.
I really like the fact that he's getting the touches he needs here after not scoring a single point in that first quarter.
Teague against Hill. Outside Teague. And he converts the layup. Teague's got 11 points.
He played an important role in their offense today, guys. Without him, they may not be in the lead.
Hill kicks to George. Hill with it. Picked up by Teague. Scola, a screen on Teague. Deflects the pass. Shot from 16. Can't hit. And Atlanta will come the other way. And there's a minute 45 left in the second quarter. Outside Williams. Six to shoot. Some solid defense from Stevenson. Indiana trailing here. It is now to Hill. Passes it to Stevenson. It's back to Hill. And George, here we go. And he uses the glass on the layup. George has got 9.
And he's starting to pick things up here after a tough first quarter.
For Atlanta, they've gone 4 of 6 from the field here in the second. Here's Williams. It's rebounded by Mahini.
You know, something that's kept this game close is the fact that rebound totals are almost identical.
No separation there. Not yet, anyway.
Now, here's Stevenson. The 3 from Hill. Rebound by Williams.
Nobody near him. He'll normally make that one.
Feeds it to Teague. pass to Brandt. And that comes off the assist by Jeff Teague. Jeff Teague's got his fourth assist with that last one here tonight. The Pacers have gone 6-10 from the floor here in the second quarter. Outside, George, and there's the feed to Scola. A jump hook, and it's in off the backboard. Scola's got his first 2 points of the night.
Back and forth we go. That basket gives us just another lead change.
And there have been too many of those to keep track of. What a contest.
Offensive rebound. Here's Williams. Nice fake with the layup off the mark.
Usually if he gets to the rim, he's converting it into points. But the defense stood tall there.
Close game as we wrap up the second quarter. Pacers out in front, leading by a point. And now we'll send it down to Doris Burke, who's standing by courtside.
Kevin, thank you. Here with Frank Vogel. And coach, you've got to be pleased with that first half. The ball was moving, your guys were sharing, things were going well for you. What about it pleased you?
Yeah, the game is simple when you make the extra pass, when you play the right way. We start out playing this way, we got to continue it for four quarters.
Thank you, Frank. Back to you, Kevin.
Thanks, Doris. And folks, the halftime show is coming up next. And then it's on to the third quarter. We'll step aside right now.
Now, presented by Sprint.
What unbelievable postseason action we've got going on so far. This is 2K Sports as we get deeper into round one of the playoffs. In Indiana, the Pacers in a close one against Atlanta. A win today would even things up in this series. A productive first half for Paul George. He's got 9 points and he's had some good court vision, helping out in the assist department as well. And on the other side, the Hawks also putting up big numbers. And defensively, they've done a good job grabbing rebounds, limiting second chances. The first half performance of Jeff Teague, just terrific. He has 11 points. He's also made plays for others, showing his court vision definitively in this one. And elsewhere, in playoff action, the Brooklyn Nets will go up against the Raptors in Toronto. They look to build on their Game 1 win. A 7:30 Eastern time is tip-off. And the other game tipping off later, it'll be the Bulls out at United Center against the Wizards. They'll be trying to even up that series at one game apiece. That one gets going at 9:30 Eastern, 6:30 Pacific. And that's all there is for me here in the studio. Time to send you back to my friend Kevin Harlan and the crew for the second half.
The Sprint Halftime Report, presented by Sprint.
Here's Atlanta now. They trail by one. Paul George is the three with David West at the four. At the one and two, George Hill and Lance Stevenson. And it's Hibbert in at the center, filling out the middle. That's the group starting the second half for Frank Vogel. Now here is Hill. Jeff Teague unable to get his shot to go. West outside. Clock at four. It's up a three. Offensive rebound, Hibbert. A beautiful reverse layup. Hibbert's got the first basket of the third quarter for the Pacers.
Well, coaches love him because of the hustle he's continually showing out on the floor. And I think where you really see it most is on the offensive board.
And you've also got to love what a forceful low-post defender he is. If he blocks one of your shots, you remember it. He sends them into the stands to make a point.
You can see the leadership qualities on display right there, guys.
It's all about communication, Kevin. You can't have too much of that as a team. And he's really leading, trying to gather his guys together.
Clark?
Well, I agree with all of that. I mean, when you're talking about orchestrating your offense and defense, that requires a lot of communication, understanding where people need to be and what everybody is doing right. And if mistakes are being made, those things have to be pointed out as well.
Free throw, no good. He doesn't get the second one. Pacers leading by three. Dishes it to Stevenson. Hill gets a screen from West. George against Teague. and a foul called on the shot. Got him on the way up that time, so he'll shoot two right here.
Looking at the game for George, 9 points, and he's put one three-pointer on the board.
Going forward, I think it'd be a good idea to let him spend a little more time behind the arc. He looks like he has a nice touch from out there.
Indiana shooting their fourth and fifth attempts at the free throw line tonight. Free throw good from George. And George drops them both. And if you're just joining us, we played over a minute here in the third. T kicks to Millsap. Right side, Millsap. And plenty of contact on the shot. So, two free throws coming up.
And no question, he got bumped on that shot.
Definitely no room for discussion on that one.
The Hawks have shot 5 of 8 from the foul line. Good on the free throw. Good on the second free throw. Pacers leading by 4. Right around a minute and a half played here in the third quarter. Hill with it. Picked up by Teague. The drive by Hill. Rebound Atlanta.
Boy, blew the easy 2 by profile. Trying to look good. That's a bad decision and poor execution.
George against Teague. Out to the wing, outside Carroll. It's rebounded by Stevenson. The Pacers have gone 1 of 3 since starting the second half. Now Hill, he kicks it to Hibbert. It's back to Hill. He feeds it to Stevenson. Just 5 to shoot, and it's good off the back of the rim and in.
Gotta love the inside-out game there, guys.
The Hawks trail by 6. Second half of play with just under 2.5 minutes gone. Here's Teague. Gets to the rim for 2 with the D all over him. Teague's got 13 points.
Well, you know, he has shot the ball well, but it has not been contagious. His teammates, they haven't had the same groove, and that's why we're looking at this result so far.
Now, here is Hill. To the left side wing. Stevenson inside the 3-point line. Good. The assist goes to Hill. Hill's got 4 assists in the game. Hawks shooting well. 50% from the floor. Millsap sets the pick for T. Terrific design on the pick play. And he lays it in. 15 points in the game.
Well, the pick worked really well there. Nice job taking it right to the 10 for the layup.
Outside Hill. He dishes it to West. Buries it down low. West has got the lead up to 6 now for the Pacers. The Hawks have gone 2-4 here to start the second half. Teague against Hill. Pass to Kirk. It's tipped. Shot clock at 6. Here's Korver. And that one goes long.
Well, I think he had all the space he needed. He just couldn't find the bottom of the net.
Hill dishes to Stevenson. Hibbert with a screen on Teague. The three from George. And that one's good. And it's a 9-point Indiana lead.
Oh, it seems that every pass they make is leading to a score here. I mean, that's just exquisite ball movement.
Yeah, they're making the right play. They're working together. And they're just looking for the best shot they can every possession.
Time call here. The Hawks decide to talk it over. Paul George really making a difference here.
He's on fire. They needed to put their heads together to figure out how to get the ball out of his hand.
A moment to check in with Doris Burke. Doris?
I was able to listen in on what Mike Budenholzer had to say to his team. He's looking for some old-fashioned offense right now. He wants the pick and roll to be the centerpiece of their game plan at that end of the floor. He also talked about creating good looks on the perimeter, saying, we can hurt them from the outside. That should be a focus. Perhaps the rest of the second half will look different after those adjustments, Kevin.
And thank you, Doris. On defense, Indiana. Since halftime, they've only allowed 5 points. Here's Carroll. Turner covering. Clock at six. Let's go. Atlanta again missing.
Boy, we don't see that too often. No defender on him, and he just clanks the open jumper.
Scola passes to Turner. Indiana moving the ball around. Scola kicks to Turner. But they get it there. And they turn over the 24-second buzzer, signaling the shot clock violation. And to make it into the postseason, you need a lot of versatility. Here's a look at the top rebounding shooting guards during the regular season. The Hawks trail by 9. Williams gets a screen from Brand. The kick out to Scott. That's going to be over and back. Not watching for the line that time. One seconds left here in the third quarter. Here is Watson. Kicks it to Stevenson. The dish now to Watson. Just 5 on the clock. 9 feet out. And so he earns a trip to the line. Officials saw the contact and he'll shoot 2. Indiana shooting their 6th and 7th free throws in the game.
The line for your Pacers, C.J. Watson. 2 shots. You got it, baby.
The first one falls. Both free throws good from Watson.
Boy, still waiting for the first miss from the foul line this half.
100% since halftime, is that right? I'm not sure this lead's going away anytime soon if that keeps up.
And Matt kicks to Williams. Tries to snap the cold streak, and the jumper is good. Williams has got 8 points.
How about that? Gets it off right in the face of the big fella. Quick release.
And operating on the perimeter like that negates some of the height disadvantage, too.
And here's Watson. Fourth quarter on the court for the Hawks. Jamari Carroll is out there with Scott. Then it's Shelvin Mack. Then it's Elton Brand. And it's Williams at the shooting guard position.
And assists like that have typified their effort today. Great ball movement.
Really an example of the difference in how these teams have operated offensively. Much more individual play at the other end.
That is good.
Little touch of class there, guys. The end of that play with the finger roll.
Pacers leading by 9. Outside Turner. Passes to Watson. Oh, and there's the alley-oop.
Nice silky finish on the alley-oop.
That sequence, I don't think Clark could have been executed any better.
Stupendous feat.
Boy, I hope we see a few more of those.
Here's Mack. 60 seconds off the clock here in the fourth. In low to Brand. Well-timed pass, and he goes straight to the bucket for the layup.
Great-looking bounce pass to set up that play.
Indiana's gone 3-7 tonight from three-point territory. Pass to West. It's good, and Watson picking up the assist. West has got the lead up to 11 now for the Pacers.
He had so much space there. Defense really not showing him the respect. You can see his eyes get wide.
Atlanta calls timeout.
He did not look too happy about some of the things he saw on the court. So I would expect some changes here.
I think it's the right move, quite honestly. I mean, they just didn't look sharp or at their best out there. So take the timeout and give yourself a chance to regroup.
And I think Doris Burke has something for us right now. Doris?
Hi, guys. I had a chance to find out what Mike Budenholzer was discussing with his guys. He was not happy with their play to this point, telling them we're getting out hustled, plain and simple. There's still time, but we've got to dial up our effort. Kevin, we'll see if they have enough to get it done.
All right, Doris, thank you very much. Now here's Teague, outside Carroll. Good.
That was simply a defensive breakdown there, Kevin. He was all alone for that shot. It was a warm-up jump.
Pacers leading by 8. Hill kicks to George. Hibbert with a screen on Teague. Here's Hill. There's the block. And they get it back. Watson for 3. No luck. And Atlanta will go the other way with it. Here is Korver. Can't get it to fall.
I like the work there, contesting that shot. It looked like it was going to be easy, but they forced the miss.
You know what? He got it in close, but couldn't finish in traffic.
Now here's West. Carroll dishes to Korver. Now the pass to Antic. And over 2.5 minutes in the books here in the fourth. Carroll kicks to Korver. Down to 5 on the shot clock. Another 3 for Atlanta.
That's 2 bombs in a row from long range.
Yeah, shoddy defense there. Far too slow to react on the closeout.
Timeout called the Pacers.
Well, good timeout, guys, because, you know, this has been a bad run for them. He's got to get his team back on the same page and executing well together.
Sometimes just getting a stop in the action can be enough to get a team back on track. There's something about that little pause in the intensity of the game that lets you refocus.
Let's find out what Doris Burke has for us.
Hey, Kevin, during that last break, I heard Frank Vogel addressing his team. The one point he really drove home was that defensively, they have to do a better job of taking away the outside shot. They're going to be dedicating more manpower to the perimeter from now on. Gentlemen, some late game adjustments that could prove crucial in the game's closing moments. Kevin, over to you.
Always great to hear from you, Doris. Teague, the pass to Korver. And Hill with the block. A bit under 3.5 minutes have passed here in the fourth. Hibbert with a screen for Hill. Feeds to West. Rejected by Millsap. Teague kicks to Carroll. And shot on the way. And that comes off the assist by Jeff Teague. Teague's got 6 assists here tonight. Pacers leading by 5. Hill inside. Teague covering. And that one's good. That's now 8 points for David West.
They're earning their points with the jump shot now.
Yep, that's 6 of their last 10 points coming in that in-between range.
Here's Carroll. Defended by George. Stolen by George. George with the jam!
Guys, that's simply superb. Ball pressure, a run out, and then a dunk in transition.
Exactly, Clark, what they want, the aggressive defense to lead to.
Yeah, points in transition.
That's why you want to make the other team feel uncomfortable handling the ball, because you can get easy points out of it at the other end.
And that replay is sponsored by Kia, the Kia Slam Cam, giving us a great look at that one. We've got 1:48 left in the fourth quarter. Teague with the ball. He's picked up by Hill. Out to the right wing. And with that shot, the Indiana lead is cut to just 7 on the basket from Korver.
And they've set up countless buckets off assists. That's a huge part of what they've been doing here today. A
lot of dime dropping going on out there, Steve.
Now, here is Hill. Here's the feed to Stevenson. This is to Hibbert. Foul call that time on the way up. That'll give him 2 chances at the free throw line here.
And what a game for Hibbert. 10 points, and when it comes to rebounding, he's had a nice night there, too.
Yeah, he's really been mixing it up in the middle, getting in there and doing a lot of the dirty work for them.
First, and that stretches their lead to 8. And the second free throw, no good. A tough break there. The Hawks trail by 8. 1:15 left in the fourth quarter. Here is Korver, defended by George. Here's Teague. It's good, and he drew contact on the shot, so he will go to the line. 3-point play chance here. Take guys on the scoring breakdown for the Pacers.
Boy, their passing has been picturesque. Thing of beauty in both halves. More than a few of their baskets have come off assists.
And they're getting the ball inside, which is what I like. High percentage shots down on the block and in the paint area.
Now, here is Hill. George gets a screen from Hibbert. George dishes to Hill. Back to George. Good. And the Pacers lead by 7.
And with that basket, you'd have to think this lead is safe.
Well, if not 100% safe, certainly 95%.
Here's Millsap. Hill with some nice D. But they're this close to putting it away.
Yeah, and they don't need to do anything to reinvent the wheel here. I mean, just take time off the clock and squeeze the orange. Don't turn it over.
Now, here is Hill. Hibbert, the pass to George. And it's Hill penetrating. Shot clock at 6. Goes up to the stripe. Atlanta with the rebound. Teague for 3. Atlanta again missing. Hill with it. So it's Indiana picking up the win. They came, they saw, they conquered.
Hey, Kevin, to me, any win is a good win.
And now, down to Doris Burke, who is courtside, standing by with our Jordan Player of the Game. Doris?
Guys, Paul George standing by with me here. And Paul, first, congratulations on the win. What's the attitude you have as a team right now?
Continue to, play together. And we can just stick to that, keep working, staying confident, keep defending, and knocking shots down. We'll be all right.
Paul, thank you so much. Guys, over to you.
Thank you, Doris. That'll do it for now. For Steve Kerr, Clark Kellogg, and Doris Burke, this is Kevin Harlan saying thanks for tuning in to the Eastern Conference quarterfinals here on 2K Sports. Now let's check out our Jordan Player of the Game.